I'm Bub Bradley Wilms.
And I'm Wilfred Manchester.
And tonight, we present the sad, tragic tale of porn star Maloney Vine on tonight's episode of The Real Face of America.
Presented by the Hill People Insurance Company.
Stillwell dropped out of high school and boarded a bus headed west to fulfill his dreams of superstardom. But when he arrived in the big city, young Ranford Stillwell found himself lost in a world beyond his comprehension. Enter Tom Sleazemore, a successful actor in the 1970s who starred in such films as The Pineapple Murders and Chairs for Hats, The Salvador Dali Story. Using the money he earned during his successful acting career, Tom Sleazemore created a small pornographic empire in the early 1980s, directing such films as Grablor the Conqueror and Seizure Town, USA, featuring his biggest star, Homunculus, also known as The Inevitable. Tom Sleazemore found young Ranford Stillwell living on the streets.
Very quickly, Tom Sleazemore seduced Ranford Stillwell with the lure of drugs, alcohol, and the promise of stardom.
Sleazemore also introduced Stillwell to his frequent co-star and off-screen lover, Homunculus.
And on that fateful night, Ranford Stillwell died, and porn star Maloney Vine was born.
Maloney Vine's first featured role was in Tom Sleazemore's production of Mr. Fix-It, released late in 1985. It became an international success.
Come in.
I hear you've got a problem with your reception.
Yeah, the picture keeps freezing. I don't know what's wrong.
Well, that's why they sent me. I'm an expert at fixing things.
That's not all that needs fixing. Wow, I bet that thing gets great reception.
You really know how to service a customer.
Satisfaction guaranteed.
Following the success of Mr. Fix-It, I gotta take a shit. Hold on.
Hey, we're rolling.
Following the success of Mr. Fix-It in 1985, Tom Sleazemore followed it up with a string of moneymakers, including The Mummy's Melon Massacre, Melon Sharks, The Garbage Man Always Rings Twice, The Return of Grablor and the Sacred Melons, and The Return of Seizure Town, USA. With his on-screen success as Tom Sleazemore's protege, Maloney Vine was on top of the world.
We'll be right back after a quick message from our sponsor. Are you a mad scientist, Nazi war criminal, or just a garden variety lone wolf terrorist? You need insurance too.
Hill People Insurance provides coverage for clones, reanimated corpses, self-aware robots, unstoppable killing machines, abominations against God, and much more. Trust your friends at the Hill People Insurance Company. We've got you covered.
We now return to the real face of America.
Times were good, and money was no object for Maloney Vine and Homunculus, who spent their days hobnobbing with celebrities, visiting exotic ports of call, and living like there was no tomorrow. But tragedy would soon strike.
In 1992, Homunculus was struck down by a severe case of super AIDS. He did not live to see Jurassic Park in theaters. Following the death of his lover, Maloney Vine fell into a downward spiral of drugs, alcohol, and hardcore bestiality.
Tom Sleazemore took advantage of his vulnerable star with one final production, 1993's Maloney Vine's Barnyard Orgy. It was never released in the United States. Following this production, Tom Sleazemore was indicted for insider trading and sentenced to 50 years in maximum security prison. After Sleazemore Studios was seized by the IRS, Maloney Vine hit rock bottom, living on the streets and giving hand jobs to old men in the park for pocket change.
Suffering from rape gout and seedlessness, in 1995 Maloney Vine took his own life, jumping off an overpass.
Though Maloney Vine died tragically 15 years ago, his films are just as popular today. I recently spoke over the phone with Steve Hightower, founder of the Maloney Vine Appreciation Society. Tell me how you discovered Maloney Vine.
I was first introduced to Maloney Vine when I was 13. My mother fell into an alligator pit when I was 5, and my father raised me in an old paint factory. He had an extensive pornography collection, and we'd watch his movies together all the time.
Don't you think it's unusual for a grown man to watch adult movies with his young son?
Some people may think it's weird, but, you know, a father and son watching porn together in a dark room. But for us, it was just a real bonding experience. Anyway, he started showing me some of Tom Sleazemore's movies, starting with Mummy's Melon Massacre, and I was hooked. It was like the single most erotic thing I had ever seen. I founded the Maloney Vine Appreciation Society in 1999 with a newsletter called Maloney's Fruit Basket, and I had over 9 subscribers. 4 years later, I moved the newsletter online to seedlesspenis.vagina. Only now do I realize that I have truly wasted my life.
Maloney Vine may be gone, but he has achieved a sense of immortality through his collaborations with Tom Sleazemore, which, thanks to the internet, are now more popular than ever. This is Ba Bradley Wilms.
And I'm Wilfred Manchester.
Join us next time on The Real Face of America.